10, 9, ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Hey, Nord Anglia. I'm Rahi Patel here at MIT. And guess what? I am armed with one of the most powerful, reliable tools for scientists around the world. Now try to find it. Guess what it is? My brain? Ha, I wish. Something in my backpack? Nope, not in there. You're getting closer. You're getting even closer. Yup, it's my phone. But why?
All right, Nord Anglia, here's why MIT scientists love your phone.
Hello, hello?
No, it's not because they can call you.
Not now, Mom.
It's because the camera in your phone is a great way to help you and the whole world learn more about science. Meet Dr. Rodrigo Garcia. He's a brain scientist who uses imagery to see inside the mind. His photo of brain cells, called First Impressions, has been on display at MIT.
I think that being able to look at some of these tiny little structures gives us so much more insight than if we just read about them in a paper or something like that.
That image that Rodrigo took actually helps scientists better understand how memory works.
Did you know that every summer, some of your teachers come to MIT to learn from some of our best? And we even give them homework. MIT research scientist Felice Frankel showed them how she takes ordinary objects and makes extraordinary images that people want to explore further. She's done this for countless magazine covers and has had her photos exhibited around the world.
It's all about science. Everything that we see around us, everything, is science. But people just don't see it that way. But when you start making pictures and you're asked, what do you think you're seeing? Then you're starting to question, not only am I seeing this, but why am I seeing it? It's a means of inquiry.
All right, Nord Anglia, here's your challenge. Take an object, something people may or may not automatically associate with science. Say, a tomato, or water. Find a really cool way to make an image of the object, like by using a flatbed scanner, your good old phone camera, or even by making your own camera.
Then present it in a compelling way so that it captures people's attention and makes them want to learn the science behind the image. And since interdisciplinary is the way to go, make sure to write a caption that explains your image to the general public.
Because what good is discovering things if you can't share your discoveries with the world? But you're not done yet. You thought we were done.
Talk about the ethics of the changes you made to your image. Did you mislead the viewer to think your object is a different shape or color? And if so, is that fair to the viewer? Make sure you're being honest and accurate.
Still want to do more? Good for you. Try illustrating a textbook. You can probably do better than some of those boring charts and graphs. So whip out that powerful scientific tool you have, in addition to your brain, and reveal the science behind your Instagram moments.